Hello, my friend. How you doing? All right, here we go again. Hello, I have worked in 20 minutes. Oh, okay. It's sad, you're right. Sorry, I didn't catch you there. Yeah, I almost did work this morning, but had the stuff to do, so trying to finish up Aragorn, so I can start to do Frodo. In the background, like a surprise hidden hawk. No, I can't do that. I need to be truthful to the original illustration. But that could have been a funny idea, like an Easter egg or something. There is something that's gonna change dramatically, even though I'm gonna keep the drawing, is Gollum. Cause, in that colored version, it's not too bad. It's just that, you know, it's white behind him. And I'm gonna make sure that we only see on the sketch version there. You can see his leg and his arm getting out of the shadow of his hole. And that's what I want to convey. I just want to see properly his arm and his leg. But the rest will be almost hidden in the shadow. It will be black behind him. And only his eyes will be really visible, almost like light. His eye is gonna shine in the shadow, and we're gonna see that in the foreground. And we're gonna see him enough, so we see him, But he will be more hidden in the shadow than he is on the on that version. Because I'm starting to see that all those, you know, really crumply branches is gonna be quite dark. So I guess the sky is gonna be quite dark as well. I can't do the sky gray because Gandalf is not gonna pop out if I do it gray. So I guess it's gonna be kind of a pale blue or something. Something really foggy. I'm not sure yet what will be the color, because I know that when you see, hey, how you doing, Cetus? Freak, yeah, love the fan art. Yeah, I love the movie, and I love this illustration so much that I have a good chance and a good how can I say that, the good luck of having somebody asking me to colorize that sketch, that you know, that version of the thing. Yeah, it's wonderful. Yeah, and I'm only trying to give it justice, which is really not the case in the colored original version, because it's all flat color and you can't really do that kind of, you know, effect, this kind of, you know, sketchy lines and everything with what they could do with color at the time. But with the ballpoint pen, you can do that, and you can even, you know, make it even more beautiful. So that's what I'm trying, give it like a real, you know, real movie kind of, you know, coloring. And I was about to say, in that sketch, which is lost in the colored version, Gandalf's beard is transforming into some kind of mist, you know, if you look at it. And then the mist is keep going behind the characters. And that's what I'm trying to do here. And what I did is that the mist is kind of gray. So we have the beard. The beard is there and it's starting to get misty. And so it's getting darker and darker, which, you know, allowed me to make the character there pop out of the drawing, because it's... And so I guess this misty, you know, this misty fog is gonna end it up in the background there. And where I started to do some green there, I guess I'm gonna drop that idea, because the green, I guess, greens behind Legolas is not gonna be good for Legolas, because he's gonna be, you know, green to green. So I'm gonna try to raise a good amount of the blue there, of the green there. I'm gonna put some blue. So I want to have like a grayish blue there. So it's kind of, you know, moody background with those branches that's gonna be dark as well. So it's very menacing, because the only problem I have with this illustration is that it's kind of a corner illustration, so it goes, you know, it's free to leave some texting over there. But as an whole, it's very tricky, because, you know, you expect Gandalf to be in the middle, but he's not in the middle because you have Aragorn there. And there is some space there, there is nothing. So if I didn't put anything there, the picture is gonna look like, you know, so I need to put some background there, but nothing really drew, just, you know, coloring. So I guess that's what's gonna happen. It's gonna be like a bluish grayish kind of color, you know, like pretending it's Gandalf spinning some kind of, you know, fog spell or something. It will give him a little bit of magic, which he don't have on the original colored version there. Yeah, I like the plan. Thanks. I like, you know, it's funny because it's one of those work that I do that I can't really think about something else. I I came back to that drawing because I can't get my eyes off it. It's, I really love my stuff. And the great stuff is that the customer only wants a digital copy of it. So that means I can keep the original. Well, it's more about, you know, the price than what you really want, because I guess, you know, you really want the original, but having just a digital copy so you can have a print is not the same price that buying the original drawing. And I'm not even sure I can really, I don't know. Because it's kind of tricky. Tricky copyright, you know, stuff where, you know, that's not my original drawing, but that's my fine art version of it, but in the same time I'm really keeping the drawing, so it's, I'm not sure I can do anything with it anyway. But yeah, I would have been happy to know what the Mike Plug think about the colored version I made of his drawing, because that is drawing. I really try to keep it really to the line, his design, because it's a really great design. I didn't have any interest to try to do it my style. I saw some version of the, you know, it's the same composition, but with, you know, like the movies, the Peter Jackson movie actors playing the role with the outfit they had in the movie, but it's losing his. It's charm as soon as you do that, because as great as Peter Jackson movie is, it's more grounded to reality. You're losing this fantasy aspect that I love in that illustration, you know. Thanks. Yeah, I'm trying to make them look real for one thing, and not too flashy. Always trying to think about the character. You know, Aragorn is the ranger, so he wears, you know, earth color. But as he's traveling a lot, you know, the colors are fast. Dirty, and his skin is kind of tainted because he's always outside. I mean, you know, I'm trying to put myself into each character except for Legolas, yeah, because with the kind of dress he has, I can't really do what I want with Legolas because he already have some dress code there, so I'm just trying to make it like ridiculously elegant and clean. Eriku! Salut! I prefer the green Legolas, almost a Robin Hood type color. Yeah. Yeah, this color is maybe too flashy. The color I put there is too flashy. It's because there is a reason. Because I knew Aragorn will have some green as well. So if I put the same kind of green on Aragorn, because what I want is that each character to pop out, you know, for their, you know, for their own. So Gimli is red. Legolas is like a good green. You know, Gandalf is gray, and Boromir is like fur and black, you know, for Gondor. I'm trying to, yeah. Funny enough, I go back to, you know, Gondor is black and Gimli is like red hair. But, and I know Aragorn will be a brown and dark green as well. So I didn't put Legolas in dark green. Otherwise, they will be like kind of the same color. Oh, that may be a leaf. Stupido, that's not the shoe, that's a leaf. Oh, it's okay. I will back in there later. Comment ça va, Riku? Ça va, petite nuit. Ah, ben moi ça va, je me réchauffe petit à petit. La maison était froide ce matin, donc mon feu est craque et ça réchauffe petit à petit. Je devais pas rester aujourd'hui ici, mais ça caille trop pour faire ce que je voulais faire dehors, donc À la place, j'ai allumé le feu et je suis en train de réchauffer la maison. Et du coup, je bosse sur mon illustration préférée du moment. C'est bien, c'est ça. Bon, j'ai mon planning qui commence à se remplir sérieusement. Alors, ce que je te propose, puisque j'ai quelqu'un qui m'a demandé un logo et tout le bazar, donc ce que je te propose, c'est que après celui-là, je suis censé bosser sur sur le portrait de Perceval. Donc j'ai bossé sur Perceval et après sur Perceval je bosserai sur ton père. Si ça te convient. Donc on est en train de parler de fin janvier, début février quoi. Autant que c'est à la maison pour le tout début mars. Après c'est toi qui vois. Bah je te dis. Je te préviens au niveau des... fin janvier, début février. Ok, là. T'as ton Riku aussi, ton Sangoku ou je sais pas qui tu voulais me faire faire, on avait peut-être pas rendu suffisamment de points, tu me diras, je sais pas. Je me dis que je peux peut-être le renvoyer en même temps. Ok, on a une jambe. Il y aura pas assez pour le faire. Bah après ça dépend du format, oui c'est sûr. J'ai une réputation à travailler vite, mais quand même. Je pense qu'il me faut quand même un stream complet pour bosser sur un A4. Donc c'est sûr que 20 minutes, ça va être un peu juste. En gros, j'ai un émo que je verrais bien passer entre tes mains. C'est quoi un émo ? Ça me dit quelque chose déjà, et ça se trouve tu m'en as déjà parlé, je me rappelle déjà plus ce que c'est. Un emoji? Un truc propre à ta chaîne? Sympa, effectivement. Faut que je pense à aller mettre du bois dans mon feu cet après-midi par contre. Hein. Parce qu'à chaque fois que je stream, j'ai une tendance à oublier. Barlow is gonna be gone for work pretty soon, so he's not the one gonna be reminding me to put some wood in my fireplace. Need to think about it. You have 5 minutes. Okay, I go now. Now we're good. We're good, we're good. We have big flame and still enough food for a good 10-15 minutes. Okay, I need to do the second boots. But the second boots have something in front of it. Do I leave it for later? Maybe. Fireball. I think I'm gonna trace Frodo instead. That's the fun part of that project, is that I don't have to think about the drawing. I don't have to scratch my head to find cool design and then apply a nice color and texture on it. The only thing I need to do is having fun with the color and texture, because the design is already there. I need to, you know, just tracing it. And that's why I'm wondering what process I prefer. Do I prefer to create my own design and coloring it, or it's just the coloring process I like? Or maybe I don't like enough my own design, I don't know. But I always find cooler what those guys are doing. But I guess, you know, the grass is always greener in your neighborhood. Because, I don't know. What I want? I want some black there. I was like wondering myself, you know, would it be cool to color an existing comic book? Like a page, you know, to see, just to see what looks like to have like this kind of coloring on the comic book. And of course, I guess it would be suit better if it's a fantasy comic book. And so I'm starting to think about Camelot. You know, it's a French comic book that reprise the series we have in France. And I never read any Camelot comic book, so I was thinking to myself, maybe I'm gonna, you know, copy paste a page, coloring the whole thing, and send it to Asti. See, do you want, you know, like this kind of coloring to do a deluxe version of the comic book or something? And I'm starting to look at the pages and I'm like, that those drawings are not that good. I want to offer promotion for your channel. Yeah, sure, of course. I'm gonna offer you something. It's my door. Goodbye. And yeah, I was surprising to see that, you know, I'm not that big a fan of those illustration in the Camelot comic book. I was more thinking about, you know, recognizing a little bit more the actors and stuff. I'm doing kind of my version of it. Because I always picture, you know, a comic book version of the series. So, but in that style, you know, in that style of, I don't know how to express myself, to explain what I have in my head. But anyway. It's just that I'm a big fan of Asti, and that would be cool to do something that he sees and think, you know, well, that's cool what you're doing. Okay, I guess I'm gonna trace Frodo now, or maybe I'm gonna trace the old, you know, Frodo Sam. We'll see. I'm gonna find. All right, we have that. Ça c'est de ce côté-là. Can use that? I can use part of that. It's kind of risky. Do I have the? Because I don't want to, you know, go, I don't know where. Part I use for Aragorn. Should be somewhere. I use the tracing to trace Aragorn. Oh, come on. Man, it's so messy in that disc. Nope, that's not it. Non plus. Am I gonna take a new one? Maybe. New one. Okay. Doesn't mind. Not mine at all. Let's take a new one. I don't like to waste things. It anyway. Okay, never mind. Well, maybe it's not there. Okay, lost it. It's a bit messy there. But what I'm afraid is that if I'm not aligned with, I can easily go a little bit. This is tricky. Yeah. Okay, looks like we aligned. Allez au travail, à plus tard. À plus tard, Barlow, thank you for coming. Okay, we're gonna try. Oh shit, it's not aligned anymore. Why? There. Maybe. Let's try that. Don't move anymore. So I guess the four hobbits will have the same cape, because I guess those are coming from Galadriel. So they will have all the greens, green cape. But I'm gonna keep those hobbit clothes, really like yellows and blue. So I'll put some color in there. I'm trying to make them really distinctive from each other. that's the process I like the least. All these tracing processes. A little bit too tedious, but if I only really want to keep the design as it is, it's the quickest and the safest. I don't have a light tablet big enough to do that, and the one I have is not strong enough for the drawing paper to get through. I guess we are good to go. Looks like we are lying. I will do the end part when I found the tracing paper that goes there. Just checking if we are good. Hello. There. Looks like we're good. We are just a little bit too high. Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to adjust a little bit here and there because there's a little difference, but that will be okay, I think. Now we put some pencil. I'm gonna put some wood. Check. That fire is hot. Compared to that room, it's something else. I don't know if it's Mary or Pippin, but in my tracing there, it looks really upset. So for those who wonder why I'm tracing instead of creating, that's not what I've been asked for this commission. The creation process of this commission is to come up with colors and texture and volumes and stuff that is not there in the beginning, but keep the drawing the way it is. So I really need to be truthful to the original drawing, because that's the whole point of it, you know, keeping the original drawing, but make it go a little bit higher. Okay, now tracing that back on the drawing. Tick, tick, tick. So, okay, I guess here we go. We'll have some minus. Yeah, it's a very small difference. That should be good. Oops. Oh, shit. Welcome to Honeywood. Yeah, there is already some issue there, but I'm gonna have to fix that and change a little bit, because looks like I'm off a little bit, but that's what we do. I think I'm gonna redraw everything first, so I'm not gonna lose the drawing. Okay. Now, I'm gonna get my eraser.
I'm gonna clear that shit.
Okay, I feel like I want to start with this little dude there, and I guess it's probably Mary, just because it looks... No, Pippin, pardon. Pippin, just because it looks younger and more scared. I need to take some decision. Colors. So we say he will keep his green hood because it's from Galadriel. So they all have this green elvish hood and cape. So that's something we didn't keep. Okay. Thank you. C'est pas mal ça, c'est pas mal. Okay, now Frodo.
Frodo, I'm gonna take the bigger
picture, guys. Want to see him better. Wow, the dude had some hair. Hey team. How are you? And how was your D&D session yesterday? Let me get my teapot set and I will tell you. All right, you have 20 minutes. Thank you.
So why Frodo looks like a girl in my picture?
So yeah, good news. The vampire is officially went rogue and is killing people out of her thirst. That's good.
That's been a while that you are after that vampire.
So me brutally murdering her is only a question of time now.
Oh, I have no doubt. You'll get her. Wait, I'm gonna put some wood in my fire before I forgot, so I can read your message. I need to figure out why Frodo looks like a girl in my picture, but we'll come that after. We had not one, but two tournament team fight last session. Wow, okay. But is it because the first one went really fast, or because you had more time? Of course, first one was a joke. We fight a beast master and it literally in the third round our rock does 80 damage to poor man and our gunner finished him off, regaining his beast incapacitability, meaning we won before I had the chance to even draw my weapon.
Oh yeah.
Well, that was quick. Second fight we had to leave and unfinished because people got tired. It's going to be a tough and promising battle.
All right. Hopefully it will last so you can get out your weapon.
This time we are facing some real opponents. They outweighed us, but a lot of theorem of HP, that is for sure. For instance, their paladin had compared to mine. Okay, okay. Yeah, all right. Is it threatening? There is some state. There is some risk there. I mean, at least at once, for once, you're gonna be able to, you know, to show what you're made of. You know, all those things that you're preparing to be able to do something spectacular. Maybe this time you're gonna be able to use them all. I believe it's already almost time. I don't feel like I did much. Just trace four hobbits and starting one that really look like a child. Yeah, Pippin in this drawing really look like a little boy. Look at that little cute little boy. Not much stuff I can do with this drawing. So if I want to keep the drawing, all I can do is adding texture and volumes and colors and voila, little boy. Yeah, sure. Frodo here starting to look like a girl for some reason. And I can't believe how much hair he has on his head. Very hard to find the direction of those hair. Okay, I guess I'm gonna stop there. I'm gonna give him some Elijah Wood blue eyes just for fun, and I think that will be it for today, because what day we are, Friday. This evening we're watching Wednesday, the series, on Netflix. It's our Friday, we are watching Wednesday. Is that clear? So
So I guess I'll be back on that drawing from time to time. Holidays are gonna start, and I promise my kids that I won't work during holidays. So hopefully I will do a little bit Sunday evening, but I'm not even sure, because you know, the day after they know school, so no reason to send the kid to bed. So I guess it's my live stream for the next 2 weeks, unfortunately. So I guess I'll be back next year, I guess. Maybe with a little bit of luck, and if they are, you know, being sent to their room because they did something bad, maybe I will be able to stream a little bit. We'll see. In any case, thank you very much for coming to say hi. Meanwhile, the fight Frank the Rock apparently enjoring the Valorant's vampire managed to get a few good arrows into the clerics and will be facing the paladin. Yeah, okay. Alright. So that will be the next adventure you're gonna tell me next year, I guess. Alright, have fun. Take care. Bye everybody. Salut tout le monde, on se voit l'année prochaine, je pense. Je pense pas que je vais streamer avant, on verra, c'est les vacances. Donc je vais pas avoir le temps de streamer. Have a good time. And yeah. And see you next time. Bye.